Yoshi.
Okay, okay.
All right, what's going on, everybody? We're getting right into it. I was waiting to try and
steal light.
Get a little pic. You know, get a little camera on my face. That's all. So we're starting right on to game one here. We got Volcarona and Red Volta. First weekly post Shine 2018. We got decent amount of people in the house today. You know, a lot of people like to take a break after they go to a tournament like that to try and recover from a long week.
It's true. But it's a very big major, so it takes a lot out of you, especially people who get really far as well.
The fact that they even have a voice right now is amazing. But neither of these players happen to go, and they are plenty hungry to try and get themselves back on the board and push towards PR for the end of the season here with the end of our life in Smash 4. Dead even game. Relatively awkward matchup. I'm not used to seeing Mewtwo versus Yoshi.
Yeah, I'm sure maybe in the States where the wall is and stuff like that.
Well, the wall actually stopped playing, so I think more like Tri-State. You got Raptor, and you got other people such as actually Freelancer moved away as well. You got Dill with his Mewtwo. That usually you'll see Yoshi try to go in a little bit more because he has to get past the length of that tail. Volcarona is doing a pretty decent job at that. Gets footstool out of a jump attempt to try and hit him with maybe an up air.
I don't see down B as being a good option in this matchup, especially with Mewtwo having hard punishment.
As getting up neutral get up right into a shadow ball, and that's going to be first blood going into Red Volta. Volcarona is still very doing very well off the start here. Should definitely not worry too much about that. He can easily seal this out.
Definitely
Mewtwo
is.
Being so light.
Ooh, that was a good option out of the egg.
Yeah, I like it. Being very aggressive, that way he wanted to get comboed off of, trying to just get the breaker. The forward air is not going to do it yet, though, coast to coast, a little bit too far.
Ooh, he's going to miss his up B, though, and he's not going to make it back. Unfortunate SD, but you know what? He was very high in percent. Maybe he would have died.
You always got to appreciate when people give you some charity. And then also,
that down air did 33%? What?
Yeah, two options just brought this game back to even. 33% off a dare and then a grab, bringing it right back. Volta still with a little percent lead, but Volcarona, even though it has been behind, has relatively looked a lot more comfortable. A little bit too far out, didn't get the sour spot to confirm into up smash.
I wonder if Yoshi, being as floaty as like he is, I wonder if that even confirms.
See, that's part of the things that I was confused about with this matchup. It's like, do most of Mewtwo strings even work? You can still use a lot of nairs, though, that way you can space him out. But I like the fact that Volcarona has been using plenty of egg toss to prevent him from being able to just kind of empty hop in with fair.
That's going to be a grab. Yeah, Yoshi's in shield a lot, but he's also dropping shield too soon. Like, he doesn't have to worry about shield poke. He just has to worry about, like, his shield being broken, really.
Yeah, he just has to, like I said, the main thing is just to zone break Mewtwo and get in past all the shenanigans. Now, Volta getting him to jump that time. He caught him last time on the neutral getup, so we should probably see some sort of option to cover that by the ledge. He's continuously puts the shadow ball out to make him respect it, but
ooh, nice call out on the air dodge.
Okay, I definitely expected him to try and confirm into the up air there because it looked like it was possible within window
range.
It
might have been true. I think so.
But opting to just play it safe, like, you know what? He's definitely going to mash air dodge because he feels scared of this right now, and Volcarona closing it out.
And you know what? That platform is going to catch it. He's going to have a little lag from it too, so that was a very smart, like,
Volcarona
very smart
option. Very underrated Pokemon, you know, bug fire, not necessarily the one that you normally want to go with, and
a
great way to get rid of bugs is to get a sword and just whale them in the face, right?
Yeah, especially if that sword goes on fire.
If the shoe's not working, get a sword. Red Volta opting to swap off. I don't necessarily agree too much because it's not like that match was far out of range. And it's one of those problems with people who play multiple characters. You want to jump to one.
The unfortunate taunt took a little damage, but.
Yeah, you didn't really take too much off of it. Could be a comfort thing for Red Volta, though, just being going to FD. I don't necessarily agree bringing Yoshi to FD with a sword fighter, but, you know.
No, not at all. Especially Roy, who wants to get in.
Probably banned Triplats, and then he felt that it was not going to work for him because he was keeping him just far enough out with the egg tosses before. Volcarona actually looked pretty decent. I haven't really seen too much of his play in recent history, but I'm liking the way it's looking so far.
Yeah, he's definitely understanding his character, and he's going to get a lot of percent off that down air.
He's consistently getting the dares and getting the B reverses to catch him in egg lay. It's been relatively dead even game so far, but I like the way Volcarona has been playing this matchup.
That's not going to be a punish, but it's going to be a shield break.
You don't need a punish when you get a free punish afterwards. You're going to get the up smash fully charged, and that's going to be the first stat going off on the Volcarona.
Again, Roy is going to kill extremely early, even as heavy as Yoshi is. I'm pretty sure he can take the stock even right now.
Yeah, it looked like, Red Volta trying to catch him on the air dodge with the F smash. Just a little bit misspaced. Could have caught him. Good confirm off of the jab into the nair there. Red Volta doesn't really look too phased. That's a good thing. You need to be able to keep your composure, especially when you go behind, and not get a little bit too antsy with your approach. That's how you take way too much trades and a lot of free damage that goes into your opponent.
You know what I really want to see? I want to see a punish on that Nair with Uppy.
You know, at some point, I've been anticipating the trade-off with the Uppy, but I think he's just waiting for it at the last minute. He's been hitting a lot of these Uppies. There it is. There's the trade with the Uppy. He was waiting for it to come through.
See, because it has the armor, so it's going to go through any move he's going to throw out. Jab, especially laggy after the second hit. It's just...
Yeah, Red Volta very playing a little bit more reactionary to the way that Volcarona has been playing. Good thing that he got the trade there with the Uppy, because that would have been it.
Have you noticed that trade did zero damage to Yoshi?
Yeah, because of the armor. Actually, no, I was at the very beginning of the startup, and this is kind of steamrolling into Volcarona's favor here.
That should have been a free punish, but unfortunately he missed his timing.
Nice delay. He didn't get, you know, he was holding back that way he wouldn't get clipped by the upbeat, which led to a lot. Almost getting hit by that forward smash. Dude, Volcarona is kind of throwing him out there right now.
He's going to get the trap. Oh, he's going to go for an immediate upbeat.
You know, it's good. It's a good thing that Volcarona is playing the way he is so far with throwing out some of these things.
There you go.
Finally catching him with the upper. That's going to be a solid 2-0 with Volcarona over Red Volta.
Very good stuff. He noticed he wasn't doing apps. He was absolutely doing nothing after that egg lay because he's like, hey, missing me with the eggs. Why do I have to be afraid?
Well, that time it seemed like he actually was trying to mash out so he could get out quick and, you know, get away from the follow-up because before he stalled. So now you're in a conditioning game on Volcarona's part. Like, okay.
Yeah.
What am I going to catch you with? And Volta fell into his trap like you were talking about before, catching him with the up air. And he was safe regardless, because even if he went in and did the up air and missed, at most he takes a falling up air, maybe a couple percent. He's
yeah,
fine.
He was low enough that he wouldn't have died off of that unless he, for some reason, got neutral feed.
The key to his success is that he just kept catching Red Volta with the egg lay. He racked up a lot of damage off of it. Not so much that he was getting with some egg toss too, like racking up damage, but... Not too bad.
It was mainly just the small percentage from the egg. He wasn't actually doing any percentage. He could have been, like, he could have attacked him a few times in the egg, racked up some damage that way at the lower percent. But still, very nice play.
Eggs are delicious. I had eggs before. I